गुड आफ्टरनून टू वन एंड ऑल. आई एम आर वी किरण, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग. टुडे इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द फिफ्थ यूनिट, दैट इज स्क्रू थ्रेड मेजरमेंट. इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द गियर मेजरमेंट. And from this class, we are going to explain the screw thread measurement, which is the second basic part of the fifth unit. So today, in this screw thread measurement, I am going to cover the introduction part of the screw thread and terminology in the screw threads. What are the different terminology in the screw threads? And this is my 46th lecture regarding to the subject metrology. So our topic is screw thread. So I start with the basic definition of the screw thread. So generally, a screw thread is the helical ridge produced by the forming a continuous helical groove of uniform section on the external or internal surface of a cylinder or a cone. So this screw thread is used to have these helical grooves, which is called as the helical ridges. So these are the helical ridges is parallel to each other, and these are formed by producing the continuous helical grooves of uniform section. So they have to maintain the uniform section based on the external or internal surface of a cylinder or cone. So you have to make it in the cylinder or both cone. And a screw thread formed on a cylinder is known as straight or parallel screw thread. So it is based on the straight or parallel screw thread, while the one formed on a cone is known as tapered thread. So when it is formed on a cylinder like this, it is called as parallel screw threads. So the threads have been parallel and in the same height. But when it is formed on a cone, so the cone is extended in some part. So they have, it is in the triangle form. So that is known as the tapered threads there. So that is used to be taken as tapered threads. So this is the view of the screw thread nomenclature, in which it has the depth between the each thread cutting. Well, this is the internal thread of a cylinder, and this is the external thread. So next we go to the classification of these threads. So according to the surface on which the threads are cut, so depending upon the cutting section of the threads, we are going to divide it. First one is the external thread. So the external threading is done in the outside part of the cylinder. So here you can see the bolt. So the outside part is threaded with the threading portion. So cutted with the threading portion on the outside part. So here in the second picture, you can see the outside threading, that is for the outside cylinder. Next, for the internal threading. So this is the internal threading for your hole. So this is for the external thread. So these threads are cut on the surface of the cylindrical bus. So these have to be of cylindrical bus also. So that is for the external thread. So that is used in the outside surface of the cylinder can part. Next one is the internal thread. So these threads are cut into the surface of the cylindrical core of bar or cone. So you can know the this is the outside part and this is the inside part of a hole. So these threads are cut into the surface of the cylindrical holder bar. So these have to be by the cylindrical hole only. So this is the internal threading point, and these are also the internal threading point, which are functionally cut into the surface of the cylindrical hole of bar or any other form. Next, according to the direction of rotation of the threaded cylinder with respect to engagement, so this is to the engagement of the first part with the second part. So first one is the right handed thread. So a right handed thread is the one in which the nut must be turned in a right handed direction to screw. So this is the right handed screw thread in which it is leaped or inclined to the left side portion. So that is, this right handed thread must be turned in a right handed direction to screw. That is, the nut must be in the right handed direction. So this is the left handed screw thread. So next one is the left hand thread screw. So this is of the left hand screw thread type, in which the nut must be screwed on the turning to its left side of the portion. So it should be moved to the left side of the portion. So here you can see the left sided part. So from the left hand view, you does not need to take the right handed screw to the, or right handed nut to the, fitted to the right hand side of the part. You need to move it on the left side of that part only. So that is of the left handed screw thread. Next one is the according to the number of starts, according to the number of game starts to each one, it is also divided. So first one is the single started thread. So a started threaded screw on which there is a movement. Of one thread for one complete turn around the screw or bolt. It is for the screw or bolt. And pitch and lead are same in this case. So this is the pitch and this is the lead. So here you can see the picture. So the pitch is the two different parts of the right hand view, and the left hand side also it is same to the lead value. So this is of the one started type, this is of the two starts, so each having a different threading portion, this having a single type of threading portion. So in the single started thread, these a start threaded screw in which there is a movement of one thread for one complete revolution during the screw or bolt, and this has to be equal in the portion of pitch and lead. So the pitch and lead portion is used to be equal in the portion. So here in the picture you can see the one started thread and the two started thread. Next one is the multi-start thread. So in this multi-start thread, there is a movement of more than one thread positioning. So the thread positioning is changes by difference. And for this double start thread, lead is twice the pitch. So the lead is doubling the pitching condition. And for the triple start thread, lead is three times the pitch. So for a triple start thread, there are the lead is three times the pitch, and for the double start thread, the lead, so this is the lead which is two times the pitch. So this is the pitching condition and this is the lead condition, so it is three times. So here we can take the lead as lead is equal to pitch into number of starts. So that is number of starts into the pitch condition.
So the letter is taken as pitch into number of start positions. Next is the V threads. So it is called as the V thread. So from the British Association, that is British Association BA, threads are exclusively used for the small screws like in clocks or etc. Thread is rounded in the form of V shape. So these threaded are in the form of rounded shape only. So, from the British Association, these V threads have been used for the small purpose, that is for the usage of the small screws like in the clocks. So, in the clocks, you will see the small number of screws, that is a small screws which have been used in the clock, which is in the form of V form, that is in the V form. Next one is the British Standard Whitworth Motion, that is British Standard Whitworth Thread. So first one is the British Association Thread, and these are the British Standards with Whitworth Motion Threads, and these are used in the general machine construction. So this is somewhat a big type of threads which is known for the general machine constructions, and these are the two types of V thread conditions. First one is of the small screw, and second one is the large through screw type. Next one is the transmission threads. So square threads are almost commonly used for the transmission of power, as in the vices, clamps and the jacks. So they have used in the transmission of power in vices, clamps and jacks, which are commonly used. And next one is the ACME thread. So this ACME thread is stronger than the square thread and easy to make it. So these ACME thread are easy to make to it. That is, manufacturing of the ACME thread is easier, and it is used in the lead screw of the lathe machine. So generally in the lathe machines, you have by taking the screw thread measurement or by taking the screw thread or manufacturing the screw thread over the cylindrical parts, these lead screw is used in the lathe machines for transmission of this power. Next one is the buttress threads. So these buttress threads resist heavy axial loads. So whenever an axial load is applied on these threads, it can resist heavily and loads acting in the direction of the axis. So it is directly axis or load acting on the direct axis also. And these examples of these uses of buttress threads occur in quick acting vices and in breech mechanism of the guns. So it is used in the breech mechanism of the guns and quick acting vices also. So, and it is also used in the mechanism of the guns. So, by using the mechanism of guns also, these buttress threads are also being really used. So, next one is the screw threads and its use. So, generally, these screw threads are heavily used to, what is the purpose of these screw threads? So, generally, what is the purpose of these screw threads? So what is, why we are using these screw threads? So these screw threads are used to hold parts together, which is act as a fasteners. So generally the examples for these types of fasteners are the V-threads, and it is also used to transmit the motion and powers. So for transmitting the motion and power, we use the square threads and the acme threads. So square threads and acme threads are highly used for the transmitting the motion and power. So generally that is the use of these screw threads and the purpose of the screw threads. So here you can see the different parts of the screw threads. So this is the crust and this is the root of the screw thread. So root means the basic starting point and crust is the highest point. Next one is the depth and the minor diameter, pitch diameter and the major diameter. So it consists of three diameters. First one is the minor diameter, pitch diameter and major diameter, and next one is the pitch. So for the external thread and the for the internal thread. And next we are going to see the terminology for different screw threads. So the different terminology for the screw threads. So there are different terminologies. You can see the crest. So this is the topmost position of the screw thread, which is called as the crest point, and this is the lowest point, which is called as the root position. And coming to the screw thread measurement also, that is screw threads also, as like gauge, it has addendum and detendum portions. So it has the addendum portions, which is the top half most part of the external thread, and below one is the dead end of the portion, and next the center of the portion, that is the axis of the portion from the screw thread to the next axis portion of the screw thread is counted as the pitch condition. So that is for the pitch condition. And next in the addendum portion, that is in the pitch line, so this is called as pitch line, which is the border of the addendum and addendum portions. And axial thickness